Now let's talk about amiodarone. This drug can prolong AV conduction, the AV refractory period, and QRS and Q-T intervals, which ultimately slows the heart rate. Because amiodarone blocks sodium, potassium, and calcium channels, as well as being an alpha and beta blocker, it is considered a multi-channel blocker. The drug amiodarone is an antiarrhythmic drug. It's used specifically for its broad range of electrophysiological effects. Amiodarone is primarily chosen for ACLS as the first-line antiarrhythmic agent for cardiac arrest because it has reliably and clinically shown effectiveness in improving the rate of return of spontaneous circulation, otherwise known as ROSC, and improved ROSC to hospital admission in adults with the refractory Vfib or pulseless VTach. Amiodarone may be considered when Vfib and VTach is unresponsive to CPR, defibrillation, and epinephrine. With amiodarone, there are multiple complex drug interactions, so care must be given when using this drug. Rapid infusion may lead to hypotension, but of course, during cardiac arrest, there's no blood pressure anyway, and therefore, the American Heart Association recommendation is still to give it rapid IV push for antiarrhythmic treatment. Remember that with the use of multiple doses, which could be a cumulative dose of greater than 2.2 grams over a 24-hour period, significant hypotension has been noted in clinical trials. Do not administer amiodarone with other drugs that prolong the Q-T interval, such as procainamide. Now, because terminal elimination is extremely long, sometimes known to have a half-life lasting up to 40 days, it can be a complicated medication to work around when treating a patient who has experienced return of spontaneous circulation, as it may eliminate the option to use certain medications until amiodarone has been effectively eliminated from the body. When using amiodarone to treat Vfib or pulseless VTach cardiac arrest, which is unresponsive to CPR, shock, and vasopressors, the first dose to be given is 300 milligrams IV or IO push. The second dose is delivered at half that, which would be 150 milligrams IV or IO push. For life-threatening arrhythmias, the maximum cumulative dose is 2.2 grams IV over 24 hours. For patients with a pulse but are suffering life-threatening arrhythmias, give amiodarone rapid infusion delivered at 150 milligrams IV over the first 10 minutes, which equals about 15 milligrams per minute. This may be repeated rapid infusion every 10 minutes as needed up to a total of that 2.2 grams in a 24-hour period. To give amiodarone slow infusion, deliver 360 milligrams IV over 6 hours or 1 milligram per minute. The maintenance infusion is 540 milligrams IV over 18 hours, which is 0.5 milligrams per minute. Remember, these infusions over time must not exceed that 2.2 gram in a 24-hour period, and when delivered as such, its effects can last upwards of 40 days.